Meanwhile, it will be one of the most controversial debates the legislature will face in 2023 in the state when lawmakers return to Springfield in just a few weeks.
The debate will decide if so-called assault weapons can be banned in Illinois. As WAND's Doug Wolfe reports, one gun dealer warns it could cripple his business and will hurt the Illinois economy.
The bill to ban assault-style weapons and limit the capacity of magazines to just 10 rounds comes in the wake of the murders of seven people during a July 4th parade in Highland Park. The measure is likely to be approved in the Democratic-controlled legislature.
It effectively put us out of business or massively cripple us.
Ethan Manning is an internet gun dealer who operates his business in Sangamon County.
We do more higher-end firearms, more collector-type stuff, and we probably do somewhere in the neighborhood of about 500 to 600 a year.
State Representative Bob Morgan will attempt to get his bill passed in the House during the upcoming lame duck session.
We urge leaders to continue to do everything in their power to ensure that no other community experiences the trauma of gun violence.
I'm really nervous that they're going to pass this in the middle of the night down to the wire. Nobody will even know about it till the next morning, or even weeks later for that matter.
Ethan says not only will smaller businesses like his be impacted, so will larger gun businesses that are producing tax dollars for the Illinois economy.
Up in like the Geneseo area, like Springfield Armory, Xander Sports down in Sparta, which are doing probably hundreds of millions of dollars a year for that economy.
The bill will apply to future gun sales. Current owners will have to register their assault-style weapons with the state police. Indicator, Doug Wolfe, WAND News.
Gun rights groups and associations have already stated publicly that they will file lawsuits if the gun ban is passed.